all over again. Season one. No, season two. Not season one, season two. Of the Pittsburgh Steelers Rebuild Series. Oh, sorry about the screen being paused. I'm currently doing something. There we go. I should be coming back on. So, we are on year number two with the Pittsburgh Steelers. You saw that I traded some players, got some good players in the last video. Today I'm going to go into more details with the way I want the season to go, because I get it, the season was short, blah blah blah, within 6-7 videos, I get it. So today we are going to do one game a video, play the full game, no simulating, sitting here actually playing the whole thing. So with that in mind, we will be playing every little detail of this game. So today, we are deciding who we are going to let start for us today in terms of the team. We will come up with starting thing. Whoever I pick to start, it's either going to be Kenny, Jameis, or Tua. And yes, I did pick Jameis was on the team last year. All these quarterbacks was on the team last year, so nothing's new. I will be right back, y'all. So we are back. We're going to decide the starting depth chart for this season. So whoever we decide to be on the starting depth chart is the people that will start for this year, unless they get hurt. What I'm gonna try to do is limit the turnovers this season. I'm gonna try to limit them. So, with this in mind, we will be looking at the season and going through the season, see how we're going to play one game at a time, but we're not going to do every single game in one video. We will not be simulating any games. If we lose, we lose. We win, doesn't really matter. My expectations for this year is a little bit higher than what it was last year, if I'm being honest. It's a little bit higher, because I got some good players, and if we can't produce nothing with these good players, then there's something wrong with the team itself. because I'm not about to keep getting more and more quarterbacks after every single season because some players don't know how to perform at expectations. So, with that in mind, we will be going into this season open-minded. Hopefully, we don't turn the ball over a lot. I want to limit the turnovers. I still don't know who's going to start. I still don't know. Haven't decided. I'm about to decide in just 1 minute. Well, I'm not going to decide in that 1 minute. But you know what I mean. So, we're going to sit here and set the depth chart for this year. I'm gonna start with Kenny. I think I'm gonna have Kenny Pickett start. Yeah, Kenny Pickett gonna be starting. Najee Harris number one running back. Then it's Tony Pollard, then James White. Deontay Johnson, Chase Claypool, Cole Beasley. I want Chris Olave at number 2. Claypool number 3. Tight end Rob. I did sign Rob Gronkowski. Might not keep him. I don't know. But I want that tight end starting over Rob. Now we're on to the defense. That's fine with me. Right ends. Cameron Hayward. Fine with that. Defensive tackle. We did draft a defensive tackle that's better than all the other defensive tackles that we got, so that's pretty good. TJ Watt, number 1. Left out linebacker. Trey Flowers. Miles Jack, Deion Bush, Reuben Foster, right out linebacker, Kawan Alexander. Corners, I'm fine with the corner position. I want to move this corner up starting this year. I'm gonna move Kendall Fuller down. Free safety, Micah Fitzpatrick, Logan Ryan, and Richard. I thought Richard was a corner, I ain't gonna lie. Third string safety, strong safety will be. I'll put him as Kyle Fuller at third string. Kicker will be him. Punter will be him. Kick returner will be Chris Olave. Yeah, hold on. Nah, Tony Pollard. Chris Olave will be kick returner, punt returner. Kickoffs will be him. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick up that wide receiver before anybody else pick him up. Because if I pick him up, don't have to worry about really anybody. So what I'm going to do is try to trade Rob Gronkowski right now. Try to open up that spot. Tua gets an upgrade. Now he's a 76. Scrambler. And just do the rookie. Nope, he's a rookie. He's already at 80. Okay, we're gonna upgrade him. We got a tough opening schedule. We got easy week 1, then we got Patriots, Cowboys, and Bills, bro. Like, it ain't no way that this is just making it this hard for us. But you know, it is what it is. I'm hoping to start the season one. Oh, wait, we have one spot open right now. Should I sign this quarterback? Let me see his player card. Huh. Maybe I'll pick him up. Let's give him that play. Bro, I'm giving y'all a draft pick, my guy. We about to play Carolina, so I don't want to give them... Wait, how long is James White contract? How long is his contract? Two years, so he'd play out the year. So let me just get rid of him, put him on the... Let's just add that double draft picks. Just give them 2 7th round picks for 2024. Let's just give them one then. So they want to make life so difficult. Let's give them a 5th round for this year. And we got him. We got that quarterback right there. So now we're going to... If Mitchell Trubisky wasn't so bad, I would love him if have him if he wasn't so bad. I kind of want Kareem Hunt. He's young too. Let's go there. Let's do this. Let's try to see if I can get Kareem Hunt and give them Tony Pollard. Let's see if they'll take Tony Pollard. They almost won him. So let's go through the draft picks and let's go all the way down here and give them a 6 1/5. I'm guessing they don't want. Safety, not giving them my safeties. What about Richard Sherman? What if I give them Richard Sherman? Richard Sherman not even starting. Nope, they don't even want him. Corners. What about Xavier Rhodes? They need a corner, so they should take him. Oop. He's not even that good. So they don't want him. I'm not about to give him them him. Nope. They're not gonna want him. Left ends, they're not gonna want none of him. They're not gonna want him. What? Okay. What? Cause I can barely hear you. And why should I do that? And you come here and give me the stuff for it. Van Jefferson's not a bad pickup, not gonna lie. What? How you gonna ask me to do something for you and you're not gonna come in here and tell me what you want? Huh?
I just had to pay an interview when we cut off of 26. If I didn't pay it,
I figured the internet was about to turn off. You wanna know why? It was slacking. It was slacking. I was gonna mention somebody, but you just gonna be like, no, yeah.
They telling me it's about to be turned off. Like, I started on the pay, but I said I'll leave.
That's what I hate about this game.
And I just got beat by something. I've been outside for 2 seconds. I just think I'll go outside.
You gonna give me the money to go up there?
Oh, yeah, it's in the car. You think I'm gonna go out this car, come all the way to his house, give it to you, go back?
You gotta come back inside anyway.
I wasn't inside, I was outside watching them. So they on their bikes.
Let me pause what I'm doing because I'm over here filming.
I'm back. I went to go get me some ice cream. Not gonna lie to y'all. So, back to what I was saying before I left. My plan is to improve this team this year. That's the plan. We got good players. We got good draft. Well, decent draft picks for next year's draft. I will say that. We haven't begun the game yet because I was gone for over 40 minutes. So, let's begin this game because I do not want to be sitting here all day. I'm not going to lie to y'all. I do not want us to be sitting here. So, this video is going to be much longer than I was planning on it to be. But we're going to sit here and begin against the Panthers. Comment down below what y'all want me to do this year for this season. Y'all want me to be more pass heavy, or y'all want me to be more run heavy? The running aspect of the team last year was incredible.
Today, from Heinz Field in Pittsburgh.
But let's begin. Hold on. Kenny Pickett is the starting quarterback for this season. I said Jameis Winston was not starting this year. I said Jameis Winston was not starting. I said Kenny Pickett was starting. Kenny Pickett is the starting this year. Kenny Pickett is the starter for this year. I'm being wise of what I throw, and I'm waiting until the opportunities are open, presented to themselves, before I throw the ball. Let's go. I did change up the defense. If you didn't see the last couple videos, I did change who the starting. I did change up who was the offensive and defensive coordinator. I said that was the key focus in this year's this year's thing. It was to change offense and the defense of coordinators. The offensive coordinator is a former head coach that got fired. Defensive coordinator is a defensive scheme. It's a new. I am changing up how I run the team a little bit because I want to be smart with the passes that I make. Touchdown. Oh, bro. That's what I hate. We just started the game and we already miss an extra point, bro. That is mad sauce.
Sam Darnold is, we know the skill set is there. May not be the most mobile or strongest arm quarterback in the league, but usually plays the really good plays, and at his best, like a home garden basketball, able to move around and distribute the rock. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big play that time on a catch and run.
He reminded us of his 1,000-yard receiver a year ago as he starts off week one, picking up right where he left off.
Oh my god, that's what I'm talking about when you switch the player. Okay. This is going to be that type of game. It's the defense. When you switch the player that you're using, it makes you get off the receiver.
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a new, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. They were successful last time finding the end zone on their opening drive of the season. And they'll get another shot here with a first and 10. Throwing to start the drive. Pickett. Flush to his right. The ball comes right, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. They're already trailing here in this first quarter. Last thing they needed was to cough the football, and they coughed it up, but luckily for them, it went out of bounds.
Yeah, still a long way to go, but when you're losing, every possession takes on a little bit more importance, doesn't it? And in that case, they almost made this game a lot more difficult for themselves by turning it over. Fortunate there. He's got one touchdown pass already in this quarter, obviously looking for number two, and definitely not playing the check down game.
To throw on third down. Pickett dancing to his left. That's complete to his tight end Freiermuth. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of first. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Well, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and it stopped him well short.
And he won't get there. That stopped him a few yards short behind the game.
Yard
so short. It'll go as a gain of four. And that's going to bring up the fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. Over the middle, it's complete.
I saw what they were doing. That was a dumb defensive call for them.
Good throw there. And I don't want to blow it too out of proportion, but he looks a lot more comfortable in his second season.
You can tell he put the work in the offseason. And what I mean by that is understanding the play.
That was a dumb defensive call for them, not going to lie.
That was the ninth play of the drive, and they pick up 9 yards with it.
fast rhythm throw there on first down and located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two, wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Rifles one completed into the hands of Brad Kowalski.
That was a round run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. He found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to one.
They'll try to run for it on first and goal. He's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's doing it about the two. From the two now, second and goal. He's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. It's a quarterback with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Steelers have once again taken the lead.
You suck. You suck, Steelers. You suck.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive series, because they would have been pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over for a little while, didn't they?
You don't know nothing!
Field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Now this one over the middle, into the hands of his tight end, complete. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. We are in for a good one as we're through 1 on EA Sports. First down, this is McCaffrey. And he works his way forward for about 4 up to the midfield stripe. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. From the 50, it's Darnold. He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 40. Here's Darnold. Going back to Marshall. He's got him again. Touchdown, Carolina. Terrace Marshall, 40 yards. And the Panthers have tied this game up. They can take the lead with the extra point. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today it's track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And with it, his guys take the lead here by a point.
It's going to be one of them games scoring high points.
Here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. And the Steeler offense set to go to work once again. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter.
We're losing by 1 measly point because of an extra point that I missed on the very first touchdown we had.
Yeah.
Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. That's how they used to call him the West Coast offense, the long handoff.
13 rushes, 60 yards for Najee Harris. Najee Harris had over 1,000 yards in his rookie season. That was last season. Najee Harris is staying on the team for a long, long, long time. Unless he gets hurt too much. And then we're talking about cutting him.
Maybe later in the game,
definitely in the second half. 11, 15 for 16, only one incomplete pass. Pretty good, pretty decent, not gonna lie.
Gross Matos there to bring him down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Back to throw. Pickett. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. The Steelers on third down. Just one for three thus far. This is third and eight. Looking to throw. Pickett. He gets it complete to Harris. And they go out of bounds after taking a little further down inside the 40.
Another touch for him on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they picked up the first down. So now on defense, you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going.
Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Corey Littleton there on the tackle. To throw on second down. Pickett. And a quick throw here. That's complete.
196.
Earlier in the quarter when we saw a broken tackle, then the new might cease from this tackles here early on in week one, and that's another one right there.
Yeah, not a surprise at all. They will even out as the season extends because they want to get used to the play speed. But right now, here in the early season, the advantage definitely goes to the offense.
Their first down screen pass, good for five.
Boy, that is certainly well read defensively. And the key to any screen play is space to work. And there is none to be found there. And a tackle for just a short game.
And he's dropped just before the line of the game. 4-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. The offense on third down tonight, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. Escaping the pressure right.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? Back to throw. Pickett. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all our friends in Port Fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Points certainly not in the premium here. And they get about three as he takes us up near the 25. And he is going to have the Panthers first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting 7 there on 3rd and 4. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Again running left, it's McCaffrey. The ball's out, McCaffrey lost it, and it's picked up by the Steelers. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
There are two words that we hear coaches say all the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the run.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Looking to throw. Pickett. Looking outside and he's got a move. That's Harris. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
Remember, this drive started off following the 10 marker. And they're taking no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there. And now they're looking at a first and goal.
Back to throw. Pickett. Zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to draw that one free.
Looking to throw on second down. Pickett to the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Not only did they drop it, it went to the interception in the end zone. They blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
They look to throw on third and goal.
Someone we threw two picks in this game.
On first and 10, Pickett flushed out right. He's got a first down pass to 30. Oh, he was out of bounds right around at 34.
It's time to fall into the category of not fair. Because when he's on target throwing the ball, he's dangerous. But when you add in his ability to make plays with his feet, almost impossible.
Yeah, exactly. They had trouble stopping him in the secondary.
Yep, two picks. 387. 9-point lead. 7 minutes to go.
No one's open, and you don't have a running lane that you want to take. Make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Eluding the pressure. And now a fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. The Steelers on third down. They've converted five times and their many chances thus far. This is third and 10. He finds his man complete. That's Harris. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Gonna be a loss of two on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down. They'll stick to the passing game as he makes the throw. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
400 passing yards.
Well, that's a big gamble for him right there. They went for it on fourth down. So the real hurt spot because it did it with the lead here in the fourth quarter. And his defense is once again unable to stop him.
Again, he'll drop the throw. Flush to his right. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Back to throw again. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a third and 10. They'll look to throw again. Throw outside, gonna be taken in by Harris. And he got blown up. Where's the yardage on the play back at the 44? Gonna be a loss of two, maybe three on the play. And that's gonna make it fourth down. Looking to throw. Pickett. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well short of the first down. The Steelers try it, but they come up.
Who knows, whatever, man. Maybe it might be time to... I don't even know. We lost. It is what it is. It is what it is. Turnovers killed us. We allowed a lot of passing yards. That's what's wrong with this team. You know it is what it is. We lost. That's cool. Fine by me. We got a tough next three games. I wanted that win because it will, you know, boost our chances of doing anything this year. But it's only week one. It's fine. We lost week one last year. We lost the first four games of the season. And we still made the postseason last year. So you know it is what it is. We don't play no division teams yet, so that's pretty good for us. We turned over the ball a lot. That's all I gotta say about what we did. It's pretty much all it is. We turned over the ball a lot. Our first division team we play is the Browns on week five. The Browns lost week one too. So, you know, it is what it is. All you can do is just hope and pray for the best for the rest of the season. I don't know, man. Because it is what it is. Like I just said, it is what it is. We turned over the ball a lot. We started a good first quarter. We turned over the ball. We got turned over the ball three times. Kenny Pickett did fumble the ball, but it went out of bounds. So that don't really matter to me because it went out of bounds. Najee Harris had 28 carries for 123 yards. Receiving Chris Olave. We had three people above 100 yards receiving, including the running back. Really much you can't really say about the team. The team did all right. It's just that defense needs to stop giving up so many yards. That's really the problem with the defense. Kicking gave up, but missed an extra point. Punting, we punt the ball once. What we should have done is we should have just punt the ball every time we needed to instead of just going for it on fourth down. I thought it would have been smart to go for it on fourth down, but you know, it is what it is. Patrick Mahomes threw for six touchdowns. What's more newer than that? Let's see. Travis Kelce had three receiving touchdowns. Juju had one. This dude had one. I thought Randall Cobb retired. I swear I thought he retired. But you know, it is what it is. Like I just said, you know, you can't really complain. Defense, you can really complain about our defense. Defense struggled. Defense had a lot of problems. I have a lot. We're number two in offense. I know the probably the whatever team is that in front of us. We're still last in defense. Doesn't surprise me. We finished last year. We finished last here. So you know it is what it is. Patty did insane. But there's a lot that I want to fix with this team. I hired a new coaching staff, thought they would step up on defense. Guess I was wrong about that. We got the Patriots, Cowboys, Bills, Browns, Bengals, Buccaneers, Saints, Browns, Titans, Ravens, Jets, Falcons, Ravens, Bengals, Chiefs, and Dolphins. We have a tough start of the season, and then we have a tough finish this season. If we don't win some of these games heading into the bye week, our hopes and dreams of the playoffs can might as well say goodbye. Let's see who already ready for a contract negotiation. Who is it? Kareem Hunt? Oh, hell no. Nigga just got signed on the team and already trying to get re-signed, bro. Like, nah, man. Like, you Like, you did one thing for us. One thing. You got one touchdown, bro. One measly touchdown. What's one touchdown going to do for the team, bro? It obviously ain't doing nothing. Miles Jack is definitely getting re-signed this year. Chase Claypool, depending on how he plays. AJ Abuye, left guard. Left guard. I don't know. Don't know. Probably not. Probably not. More than likely not. Probably. I don't know. Don't know. Don't know. Don't know. Maybe. Probably not. Well, probably. And probably not. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to try to trade Kareem Hunt. Let's see who would be interested in Kareem Hunt. Kareem Hunt is a 90 overall running back. I don't know who needs a running back. I really honestly don't know. But we're gonna add him to the Bears are already interested in that man. I don't know. Maybe they give me a 16 overall pick for him. Oh yeah, I got the. That was easy. That was real easy. I should have asked for more. Maybe. Let me try to get rid of Rob Gronkowski. He's old, so I don't think anybody's gonna want him. I don't think, well, Titans are interested in it. No, Chargers are interested in him. I don't want nobody for him. I just want a pick. That's it. That's it, all I want. Let's give them some picks that would wow them. Let's give them some players that would wow them, I mean. Eddie Goldman, they should be interested in him. They're not interested in that man. The only thing I can say is to give them him. That's really all I can say. How did he do in the week one? He did good, so he ain't going nowhere. I don't know. Let's see if anybody's interested in him. Let's go Lions. Aiden Hutchinson. Ooh, I can get a left out linebacker right now. What? Let's give him too. We almost got him. Let's give them these players. Bro, like they got so high interest in this trade right now, bro. Let's give them my last fifth overall pick. Bro, they want him so bad, bro. Let's give them fourth. And we just got Aiden Hutchinson. Good. We got Aiden Hutchinson. I'm gonna change his position. There's a lot to do here. I don't know. And let's start training. We're second in offense, so that's pretty good. Right behind whatever that damn team is. Who got hurt? Did anybody get hurt? I don't think anybody did on offense. Nobody on offense got hurt, so more than likely people on defense. Yep. Miles Jack got hurt. Wait, who is that? Yeah, Miles Jack got hurt. And that's it. So, you know, it is what it is. You suffer injuries all season. let's upgrade our players, and then let's end this video. Oh, okay, we got a couple of upgrades. Set an 83 overall now. Devin Bush. 83 overall now. Damn, you got plus one in everything pretty much. This dude, I was gonna think about it straight, but he, I don't know. Miles Jack got hurt and he will be out for this week's game too. He out 1 week. 94 overall. Over our left guard. You know, it is what it is. We got some decent players out of this. I'm gonna end this video here. I hope y'all enjoyed it. This is the last video I will be doing today. I'll do a video tomorrow, and I'll see y'all tomorrow.